not be sending anything into it at this point.
Well.
I think that's weird.
Thank you.
just want to say, all I want to do, Mr. President, I just want to welcome you, and I just want to tell you that they've been waiting, you know. They publicized that you were going to be here, so they've been waiting. And they've been waiting, and since they started at 10 o'clock this morning, and they've been waiting for you. And I can't tell you how happy I am that you're here, but I thought with this particular crowd that you might drop in by parachute.
Bob, I'll leave that to the experts. If I tried that, I might have landed on your birthday cake.
Yeah, the seat of government would have icing all over it, huh? But, you know, it's great to have you here. I'm just sorry Nancy isn't with you.
Well, I was going to ask her, but I was afraid she'd just say no.
I want to tell you, Mr. President, with all the travel and all the work you've done, you look just great.
Well, Bob, you look great, too.
You do. Well, I hope I look that good when I'm your age. You know, if vaudeville comes back, we're set.
Robert, I just want to say something to all these people here. And that is that I'm sure that many of them know this has been a career with you. On birthdays, on holidays of all kinds, dating clear back to the draft days before World War II, you were out entertaining our people in uniform. And then through three wars, you went wherever our fighting men and women were to bring a little touch of home to them. And you left and you were there, and now we're at peace and you're still doing it. And I think it's just great of you. But also, I would like to say on behalf of your audience, nothing in the job I have has made me more proud than these young men and women in uniform. Believe me, Bob, they are the finest we've ever had.
Well, we are ready. We are ready down there with the queue. How about that? You ready? See it. Les?
Oh.
Thank you. much for coming. You've given us all a great thrill. Where are you off to now?
Bob? I don't know whether I can do it to a musical background.
We got to talk and dance at the same time.
Well, Bob, in my lapel is a button. I have just come from Tuskegee University for their commencement over there, and where a gentleman named General Daniel Cappy James was being honored today.
No kidding.
His widow was there. Yeah, this great general.
Great man. Right.
And you all can't see it, but there's a button here in my lapel, and it says that I am an honorary Tuskegee Airman. But Bob, your birthday and all, and I know that I have to leave because from here it's Washington, but just before I leave, I just wanted to tell a little story that I thought they might be interested in. You know, Bob does have time to have some fun other than just entertaining like this. Now, for example, out there in Los Angeles, we've got a couple of racetracks, and Bob was going to go to the races when Hollywood Park opened. And for 3 days, or 3 nights, I should say, he dreamed of number 5. So he went to the track when it opened, and he went right down the program to the 5th race. And then to the number 5 horse in the 5th race. And it was named 5x5. He bet the bundle on it. The horse came in 5th.
I love it. I remember when you gave me a tip years ago at the Kentucky Derby. It's the first horse I ever saw make a pit stop. Anyway, it's a thrill to have you here. You've thrilled a lot of people here, and they've been waiting for you. As I told you, it's at 10 o'clock, and you're awful good to show up.
Well, Bob, thank you for what you continue to do for all these young people, and thank all of you for what you continue to do for our country.